Hey everyone, I'm Melanie from Streamline Legal, where we help law firms get the most out of their practice management software. One thing that we recommend a lot at Streamline Legal is using the forms within Clio Grow. Not only using the forms to email them to your client so that your client can fill them out and send you information or your potential client, but also completing them internally. Sometimes it's a lot easier just to hand an intake person on our team a form to fill out than to have them go in and manipulate a bunch of different custom fields in Clio Grow. And so oftentimes we'll recommend that when preparing a form in Clio Grow, we create them and prepare them with our team internally as opposed to sending them out to our clients to fill out. And I'm sure you've had the experience before, anybody who's using forms with your clients. Sometimes they send them back, sometimes they don't. So maybe we want to go in and fill it out on their behalf on a phone call or something like that to make it the process easier for them. So tonight I want to talk about when your client gets a copy of that form, because there are times when you fill out that form that your client will get a copy of that information, and there's other times where they won't. And of course, if you're filling out internally, someone on your team might be writing notes in there that are sensitive that they don't necessarily want the client to see. And so we want to make sure that we're very clear on when the client is going to receive a copy of that form and when they won't. So I want to show you there's a magic button. Not really magic, but it seems magic, that's going to control this. So let's take a look at our Clio Grow screen. Right here, I'm in a Clio Matter, and I'm going to go ahead and in our workflow, I'm going to go ahead and prepare a form. And I'm going to stick with this form here. I've got my matter here. I'm going to go ahead and stick in my client there. That's the contact whose information will be on the form, right? Then this is where the magic takes place, right? If I leave this button clicked by default, it says share form link with contact. If I do that and they fill out the form, they will receive a copy of the completed form for their records. However, if I click on fill out form now, then it's not going to send the client a copy of the form that I fill out. So if I'm using this form internally and having someone on my team fill it out, I want to make sure that we're clicking the fill out form now button and not the share form link with client. Okay. So if I do want to share a copy, I want to send it to my client, have them fill it out. They'll get a copy of everything. Of course, I leave it on share form link with client. I put in who's going to fill out the form, and then I'm going to go ahead and say get form link, and it's going to take me to the workflow that allows me to send out a templated email for them to fill it out. And again, when we do it this way, they're going to get a copy of that completed form. However, if I skip this part and instead I go ahead and click on fill out form now, they will not get a copy. So keep this in mind, because if you have clients coming into your office, and maybe as we start, the world starts to open up more and we have more people coming into the office, maybe we're handing them tablets, maybe we're allowing them to fill it out electronically in our office. If we do that and say fill out form now and hand them the tablet, they won't get a copy of that data that they've submitted. Maybe they're okay with it. Maybe you don't mind that. Maybe they don't need it. But just keep in mind, these buttons are the key. This button will send a copy to our client of the information in the form. This button will not. So keep that in mind when you're using your forms. We wouldn't want any sensitive data to be passed on to our client that we didn't intend. So please do train your intake people with those two buttons. Thanks for joining me tonight. Have a great evening.